people, not all dogs can be models on the runway. But wait a minute, animals are not supposed to wear clothes in the first place. And yet, they are. Pet shop owner Stella Chen said more people are dressing up their furry friends.
More ladies are coming in to buy for their pets, okay, and they want to dress the pets up when they go out, especially like dog events, you know, like East Coast, West Coast, yeah. They do come in to buy t-shirts. When I first started, very, very little, maybe a month, about 10. Then right now, it's roughly about 25, 30 per month.
The demand has also pushed up supply. Freelance designer Ai Wei set up a blog shop in October selling bling bling pet collars for between $29 and $59.
I'm very thankful by the very great response that I received, especially during Christmas and New Year.
So how many collars have you sold since October last year?
I think close to 200 already.
That's pretty fast.
Yes.
Jess Ng wants to cash in on it too. She's set up the Mudley Crew, a shop catering to trendy corporate women from their 20s to 40s.
Like in Japan, smaller dogs, dresses, but the big dogs, right, we have like nice collars and like, you know, berets for them. So dressing is not only like, you know, t-shirt, it extends to like nice collars as well. So these are like for big dogs too, you know, so yeah.
So do you think there's a rise even where big dogs are concerned?
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. I mean, like in Thailand, even Thailand, like the pet industry is worth $14 billion. 14 billion, and it's just our neighboring country. So, yeah, and I think that Singapore will definitely catch up. That's why I want to enter the market fast. Yeah. Nowadays, I feel that dogs are like our kids. So, that's why we are willing to spend on it. That's why I set up the Mudley Crew like for this particular like class of people. This particular brand here is from Doodletons. This just came in, but I've already got one or two like people buying it. But this just came in like this month. So, and a lot of people like it. They're like, oh, so cute. And yeah, and it's really good quality, you know. And it's more of like, you buy one piece, right, you can keep it. It's like those doll clothes, you can, collector's item, I would say. Because she do very limited pieces, all handmade. So if you want it, you have to buy it fast because she wouldn't produce it anymore. It's like buy collections.
Even though pet fashion may make good business sense, but dressing up animals just doesn't make sense to some.
Okay, now, do you think pet fashion is more for the owners rather than the pets? Like, they actually, you know, it's the owners who are being vain, not the pets.
Yep. Okay, because from the time you pick up from the shelf, you choose for your dog. It's not your dog choose the clothes. You get what I mean? So, everything is the owner that makes the decision whether the dogs like it or not. The owner just put it on, so I feel it's really just the owner's decision to do everything. But for shoes wise, right, it depends, because our weather is it's tropical, so it's like they tend to have flea and ticks easily. So going down wearing shoes is fine, but the paw pad must have friction so that they do not strain their muscles.
So it can be harmful if it doesn't have friction.
Yes,
I see.
Well, Stella is not alone. Other pet owners tell us why they won't dress up their pets in the next clip.